so much. I'm very happy to stay here in Leeds University with you, sharing ideas about open education, and thank you for this opportunity. A few years ago, we had the opportunity to watch the film Pay It Forward, or Chain of Favor, Cadena de Favores in Spanish. Do you remember? The one where we were invited to open our eyes and become aware of how we can possibly affect the well-being of others. There were histories of altruism, concern for the common goods, trust as a basis for action and impact in the world. A similar chain that Leonique and I will invite you to think and act on today in this field of open education and the declaration of the Knowledge Equity Network, KEN. The aim of this section will be to share some ideas about open education, open practice, open educational resources, and to pose some questions to you to invite reflection and share action too, of course. As all of you will know that in the year 22, UNESCO invited university to open knowledge. That is when we start to hear about open educational resources, OER, open science, open practice, open all, and open platform too. This development that led to various declarations, and recently in 2019, UNESCO issued 5 recommendations to member countries. 1, capacity building to increase to ability to create, access, reuse, repurpose, adapt, and redistribute OER. 2, development of supportive policies that encourage government, educational authorities, and educational institutions to implement OER and open education. 3, effective, inclusive, and equitable access to quality OER that promotes the adoption of OER strategies and programs. 4, promote the creation of sustainability model for open educational resources and open practice. 5, promotion, support, and facilitation of international cooperation like we are here today. In the same vein, last week we had in Paris the celebration of the 30th anniversary of the UNESCO Chair with the theme, Transforming Knowledge for Use and Sustainable Future, where the recurring themes were the call to build together the future of education with interdisciplinary collaboration, equity, construction, and actions. Ideas connect knowledge for social transformation, of course. Many ideas were put forward, but there were clearly shared lines. Collective action, hospitality, inclusion, available, common goods, interdisciplinary, co-construction, network for sharing values, data, technologies. As a link in the open education chain, today we have a new invitation through the KEN declaration, which starts from the principle of universality, collaboration, inclusion, and the sustainability as substantial elements for all. It gives us general recommendation for creating a culture of openness, access, equity, and co-creation. It's made recommendation for institutions, funding agencies, publishers, and for ourselves. As active actor for open education based on collaboration, discovery, and knowledge creation. Again, this background, I would now like to share with you some brief reflection in open education practice. In the Open Education Journal, we can say that we have come a long way and still have great barriers, of course. For example, we have seen the amount of open education resources grow. However, and we still have the barrier that they cannot be shared in different languages and with attention to diversity. We are increasing the possibility of open education resources in terms of their use, production, dissemination, and mobilization in formal and non-formal institution, but we know that we still have large gaps between the production of value resources and their integration into educational practice that support lifelong learning. We also seen evidence of open network making an impact in the community where they direct their efforts. However, we also know that this impact is reduced for vulnerable population where basic electricity and internet service are not available. We have witnessed the growth of institutional thematic repository, but we also know that this perspective academic community are not taking advantage of this infrastructure, not to mention the institution of which there are still many that do not have repositories yet. We are aware of changes in teaching evaluation practice where the evaluation is based on the production in the repository, but this practice is still far from being mainstream. We rejoice and very happy when we learn about international, such as those of UNESCO, national and institutional policies. But when we analyze this adoption, we conclude that there is still a need to grow in the monitoring and evaluation of the fulfillment of these policies. And so, I could go on with a long list of open education challenges of step forward and intermittent stop. And in this evolution, we know that as an active actor, we have a commitment to the democratization of knowledge, to education for peace, solidarity, equity, and intergenerational duty. Following this invitation to collaborate with KEN today, I would like to ask you, how might each of us contribute to create a culture of open access in our institution and in our context? How can we generate open practice that promote the generation of value for and useful knowledge for the betterment of society and the common goods? And just as I begin this story by referring to the film Chain of Favor, Cadena de Favores, so I would like to invite you to think about this. What can be your link in these chains in order to be an active actor and contribute to the opening up of knowledge, equity, and quality education for all? And finally, I would like to share with you a phrase for the Maya in the South Mexico and in Central Latin America. The Mayas, they every day express this concept of unity in their daily greeting. In lack age, which means I'm another you. To which they reply, a la Ken, which means you are another me. Thank you so much.